Yes.
I told you that we really have to do this. I wrote and sent something to you.
President Tom Turner?
Yes.
How do you do, sir? How are you? It's nice to see you.
Well, it's good to see
Thank
you.
Let me take this opportunity to tell you how much we appreciate what you're doing for us.
Well done. Thank you very much, and I appreciate what you're doing for our country.
My secretary is named Sharon Rankin, and her husband is a brigadier general in the Air Force and works on the SDI. And I said, should I tell the president anything? She said, tell him we love him.
Well, let's give them a...
Mr. President, there's one item of business in connection with Tom Turner's confirmation. Senator Cranston has written him a letter, and he wants the assurance that all matters pertaining to the VA, all matters pertaining to the budget of the VA, he will have access to you or your top assistants, and I want to assure him, and I want him to be able to say that he's spoken to you about it, it will be done.
And I want to assure you that without Senator Cranston sticking his nose.
Sir, from my experience with you in California, I didn't need the words. The background and the track record tells it all, but okay. I appreciate that. But I think part of the reason for this meeting was to be sure that I could go back and say again, I have an assurance.
Okay.
All right. Thank you, sir. It's good to see you. Thank you.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
It looks very nice. I can't see a single spot of that snow left now. Until this weekend.
Yeah,
they're
colder.
Saying it's going to be colder and maybe some...
High in the 30s.
Let's say it's quite a bit colder up there, doesn't it? Camp
about 10 degrees. It runs about 10 degrees. In the summer, that's great. It's about 10 degrees colder.
Hi, Mr. President. Hi. How are you?
Just fine.
Thank you for having my family in. It's great. This is Christine, Mr. President.
Hi, it's an honor meeting you.
My wife, Teresa.
Hello there.
It's such an honor meeting you.
Well, this is my mom.
That's Courtney.
Hi, yeah. Nice to meet you.
I just had a birthday this week.
Yeah.
Listen, this is really a Reagan family now. They traveled when I went down to Nairobi and had a great time. They were in a coup. When we were down there, as your ambassador.
Well, I thank you for doing what you were doing. And. Shall we get a...
Yes,
great.
A family photo, absolutely.
That's great. How are you doing, Mr. President?
Just fine.
It was a good vote today in the next one.
Thank you.
Which one was
it? The Armed Services Group.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Lost two.
Yeah, that's okay. Keep plugging it'll work.
We're rooting for you. We pray every day for you, and we're just so proud to be able to observe you.
Well, listen, I thank you for what you're doing. I know that you're a double volunteer.
Oh,
and
I love it.
It's wonderful.
She works in Fred's office
occasionally.
The Irish Mafia up there.
That's right.
Well, listen,
that's right.
Mr. Wallen, there's Mr. Kim for you.
Thank you very much.
Tybar for you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
And her.
Well, isn't this nice?
And here is the jar with the seal engraved upon it. Inside the jar are jelly beans.
Ah, great.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Mr. President, it's so nice to meet you, really. We're just your biggest fan.
Thank
we
you.
We should get to stay up all night to see the elections, the voting.
Yeah.
School.
I thought I was the only one.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you
thank
so
you.
Much.
Thank
very
you.
Nice
you.
To meet
you.
Take care.
Thank you. Thank you.
Right out.
Just talk to him on the phone.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Because he's on my side on the contrary.
Very good. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Mr. President.
Frank Johnson, Washington. How are you?
Just fine.
It's a picture I made in Vietnam, one of the tunnels. Oh. Chi.
This is I love that museum.
Yeah. This is one of the Viet Cong soldiers and his assistant, sergeant, who worked with him at the time during the war. I went back to their 10th anniversary to cover that, and I toured through the country.
Well, yeah.
So the countryside.
Well, all right.
Thank you. Nice to see you.
Mr. President, Tom Coulson, National Geographic.
Well,
nice to meet you again. This is a picture I took in Switzerland during a day called Langsgemeinde, where the Swiss community come out and show their hands on a voting process.
For heaven's sake.
And that's their process of democracy. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah.
That was good.
Hi. How are you?
Thank you. I think you probably don't want to talk about
that. Now, who is that?
Couldn't have done that.
And I thought I'd have to.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Margaret Thomas from the Washington Post. And here's two vague children looking for Big Bird.
Oh.
And a wind came by and blew their umbrellas.
Well, yeah, that's cute.
Not every mother dresses her kids in bags.
Hi, Mr. President. Daryl, thank you. Nice to see you, sir.
Nice to see you.
That's a reflection of the way I was fed in Vietnam.
Ah, of course. I was wondering. Yes.
Someone that I knew and lived in the nice.
My gosh, yes. Very good.
Thank you very much. Nice to see you.
Mr. President. Nice to meet you. Dana Smith from the Washington Post. This is a picture of one of
the tallest. Oh. You catch that with that fire you sighted?
Mm-hmm.
And that's...
Thank you, sir.
That's pretty good timing.
Yeah. Thank you.
Hello, Mr. President. Rick Kozak from Washington Times.
Well, good to see
you. Nice to see you. Here's a little story we did on the, it's a whole big one. One more. This is when the Amish were built after the tornado in Pennsylvania.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
Got destroyed and just...
You better turn that around for
okay.
You.
Okay. How's that, huh?
Thank you.
Good. Rick McKay, Cox Newspapers. TWA hostages when they came back.
Oh,
out at Anders.
I remember that.
Yeah.
Yes.
The guy got off and picked up his niece.
His little niece jumped for him.
Thank you.
Thank you.
These are all the television cameramen now, Mr. President. They won't have any stills to give you, but.
All right, it's an honor.
Nice to meet you.
Well, I wish I got the anniversary. A little late, but.
Thank you very much.
Sir, Paul Fine with CBS. I wanted to know if you watched 60 Minutes 2 weeks ago. You saw a retarded couple.
Now wait a minute. Yes, I think.
The black and white person.
Yes.
I believe it produced that, and the couple want to know if you watched it. So.
Yes, we did.
Okay, good.
Usually, right. Something big for us, is it?
Okay.
Mr. President, the next gentleman won for the best lighting.
Hello, First Lady Special. She can rid them. She's playing with that.
Well, good to see you.
The next gentleman is the best sound.
Mr. President, Jeff Goodman, NBC News. How are you?
Yes.
Nice to see you.
The best editor?
Mr. President, Mr. Kosky, NBC. My little sister is a lady that danced for you with Fernando Bahamas. Marianne Trakowski. Yeah.
You very much.
This is one of the final cameramen.
Hello, sir. Estel Dillon, how are you?
Just fine.
NBC. Nice to meet you.
Nice to see you.
Take care.
Get the.
can't see some of the faces, Mark. Come on up.
I'm looking at the guys.
If you can't see it, you can't see it.
I can't see it.
Big smile, that's a smile.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Well, listen, thank you very much. Souvenirs here for the occasion.
Oh, my.
There's supposed to be one right here, isn't there? One missing. And gentlemen.
Thank you, sir.
Hey, sir.
Touch with Larry Speaks already, and Pete, and we hope to have a good evening, and we've got a tape that we're putting together of all the former presidents, and it's a good video thing we're putting together. So we look forward to seeing you. Thank you for the session here.
Right. Sorry to be so late here.
Oh, my goodness.
It's the hottest thing in the morning. We're already on the lunch schedule, Mr. President.
Hi, Charles.
John.
You're good. How are you?
Good to see you.
How are you?
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
There's a light in there on the throne.
He was head for 9 years and handled 65,000 exchanges around the world. And when we had the President's Youth Initiative that you introduced at Versailles, he helped put the whole thing together. It's been magnificent. He's so excited about this challenge that he's left his consulting business for a year or two or whatever. And he had been here as a consultant to the World Bank on management sciences and also INTELSAT. So we had, with the cooperation of the NSC, and state, we had good representation. We had 19 meetings with the key leaders there who are responsible for culture, radio, sports, the whole thing, embracing the agreement. The bottom line is Arthur Hartman sent me a cable and he said, I don't know how you will be received. They've been attacking me.
Harry. He's done a great job. I know he'll do another one for us.
we're going to have a frequent flyer program for him regarding the 250,000 miles he's logged in Central America. The place isn't that big. There wouldn't be that many miles, but a lot of baggage. So I'm deeply grateful. And to you, for your post-election and post-Marcos trips out to the Philippines, as I say, first of all, they said, Mr. Duarte, he's just made a proposal that he'll meet with his dealers if the Sandinista government will meet with the people simultaneously. They're going to have a little tough time refusing that since they've been supplying his guerrillas their arms and weapons, Sandinistas have. But we want to hear now that all the things we need to know about future policy.
President, on the Philippines, I think that we've had a success in the sense that the transition was quick, it was clean, very little bloodshed, incidental bloodshed, but really nothing to do with the transition. And I think for that, everybody is grateful. And for that, I think we and you get a bit of credit with the Filipinos. They understood the crucial role in bringing that about and doing it in a very quiet way. I think that Mrs. Aquino has started off well in a good cabinet. We know almost everybody in the cabinet and we know them well.